Take one, episode one. Kathleen's tits. I mean, tips. It's here. Hi, and welcome to Kathleen's tits. I mean, tips. We're gonna talk about how life can be much more simpler for you at home. And with simple little tips around the house and things that you can do, just make life real simple for you so you can watch more TV, soap operas, or whatever you like to watch during the course of the day. So today, as a matter of fact, my husband and I, we were working out, and after he got dressed, he put on his shirt and clothes to go to work, and he noticed his t-shirt was a little, had a little stench in it. I'm gonna tell you, it was funky. So I said, honey, I'm sorry about that. I'm gonna fix that. So we're gonna talk about how to clean your front load washing machine today. And it's not very difficult, it's very easy, but that's something that you should do at least once a month. So let's start with that. Okay, so follow me and we're gonna do it right now. Front loading washing machines are very energy efficient and they take less detergent than the regular normal washing machines. So right now we're gonna clean our washing machine and I'm gonna show you how to do it. And this is what you need. Voila. What you're gonna need is 2 cups of vinegar, white vinegar, and you'll need 1/4 cup of baking soda, and 1/4 cup of water. And what do you wanna do first is just, I already have it pre-done, take 1/4 cup of water and put it in a nice little pan and mix it up. Mix, 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 mix. I should move it like that. Mix it like that, okay? And then we have our sponge handy. Now what we're going to do is actually go out and put this in the washer. Okay, that's my man, honey. When I come out here, my incentive to wash my clothes. I have a huge 3-car garage, and this is where I keep my washer and dryer. It's very convenient, right close to the house, come right out the door. So right now, we're going to go ahead and put everything in the washer and let's go for it. Okay, now here we go. We have our baking soda and water, 1/4 cup of each. You're gonna put it right in here. Bring it, come in here so we can see the dispenser, Narayan. We put it in where the, see, it might stick a little bit, so just make sure you get all of that baking soda in here. It's key. We wanna fight all that mold and fungus and stanky, stanky stuff down there. So that goes right there. Then we're gonna close it up and put it on the hottest, highest wash you can. You want really to sanitize it. So we're gonna go to sanitary here, and that's the hottest heat. It's gonna be 2 minutes. That's quite a long time. But the key is, before you do that, you're gonna take your vinegar and you're gonna actually put it in here. You're gonna drop it in the machine. You're dropping it in there. 2 cups, that's a lot, I know, but drop it right in there. And then go ahead and turn it on, walk away, and pray. There it goes. Okay, see you back in a little while, and then I'll show you just how to clean it up with the sponge. Very simple. Okay, and now that it's finished, we open it up, and voila. Now you can't really tell it's clean, but it's clean, but you wanna take a damp cloth, your sponge, and wipe around here the residue, because we do have a little residue in here that was left by the baking soda. But take it, and it gets out all that mold and smelly stuff and everything, but it just makes it a lot nicer and cleaner. Oh, I can smell it already. Okay, so there you go, very easy. But you know what, I wanna give you one more tip. Now that we've cleaned it, what really, really makes my wash so fresh and clean is I like to use Gain. So for the top loading washing machines, of course you put the Gain in here. And then what I do, I put my Downy fabric softener, which smells so good, in the fabric softener little place right here. And here's the key, people. Oh my God. You can either use Fabuloso or Awesome. Any kind of really like floor cleaning detergent or something, don't be afraid. I like the lavender. You take a little bit and you pour it into the dispenser where the Clorox goes. if you're not using your Clorox, which I don't use a lot of Clorox, and use this, and I guarantee you, it's gonna smell so very, very clean. So fresh and so clean. So fresh and so clean, clean. Hey, hey. Thank you for spending time with Kathleen's Tips. Tips. Come back again. We're gonna have something real special for you.
Waking up out of my slumber, feeling like Rollo. So follow, it's showtime, and it's Apollo, man, it's the Kiki Shepherd.